Why would tens of thousands of zebras living in a paradise leave to take a long, risky journey into an unpredictable land? If the mystery can be solved, one of the world's last migrations may be conserved. But can the zebras adapt to a future where climate change may be the greatest threat of all? In 2007, scientists became aware of a totally unexpected event. Plain zebras living in the rich Okavango Delta in northern Botswana resumed a 588-kilometer round-trip migration not undertaken for over three decades. A migration resuming had never been shown before. The reason? Livestock fences erected to stop the transmission of foot and mouth disease from wild buffalo to cattle had been taken down. Animals trapped by the fences were free to roam again. Just as free as you are to like, share, and leave a comment under this video. It helps us a lot, so check out some more videos after this one and please consider to subscribe to our channel if you like our content. Thank you very much, and now back to our monochromatic migration. Scientists were puzzled. In the wild, zebras do not live past their teens. So there is no way even the youngest foals could have learned the migration route from their mothers. Did some innate ancestral knowledge within the zebra trigger the journey? And why leave in the first place? Especially when these zebras are already living in one of the most pristine, protected oases in Africa, the Okavango Delta. The delta is an 18,000 square kilometer freshwater wetland, which forms in the desert of northern Botswana. It's a sanctuary to the largest populations of wildlife in Africa. Here, life is completely in tune with the seasons. There are just two, the wet and the dry. Curiously, it is the dry season that is the wettest in the delta. Rains that fall 700 kilometers upstream at the source of the Okavango River bring trillions of liters of water, which can take up to 6 months to reach the edge of the wetlands. The delta also has permanent marshlands, so the Okavango Delta can sustain life year-round. There is no compelling reason to leave, but leave the zebras do. When the dry season comes to an end in November, around 15,000 animals set off. That's not all of the population. 45% stay in the delta. No one knows why. Those that choose to be nomads turn their backs on paradise to travel southwest through a desert where there is no water, except for some rain-filled depressions. It will be a few weeks before they reach their destination 300 kilometers away. The Makadikadi salt pans. What could possibly be worth the risk? Could it be that the grass is actually greener? The destination the zebras have in mind used to be a massive inland lake that covered an area larger than Switzerland. That was thousands of years ago. Now, it is the largest network of salt pans in the world. During the dry season, while the Okavango Delta is in flood, the Makadikadi salt pan is a scorched land. Patches of rich grasslands and palm trees interrupt the salt-crusted surface. With the arrival of the spring rains, the grass becomes lush and extensive. It's also highly nutritious. At Makadikadi, zebras can get 2 to 3 times as much nutrition from the same volume of grass that they would eat in the Okavango Delta. And that is why the zebras come. The extra nourishment also means they can have more young. It's not only the Okavango nomads that make the long journey. Other migratory zebras from the north arrive in their thousands. It's a good place to meet a mate. But around March, once the rain stops and the dry season returns, the salt pans evaporate and the zebras must head back to the Okavango Delta. So, how do the zebras know the grass will be growing and the water holes filled nearly 300 kilometers away in Makadikadi, before they even leave the Okavango Delta? Scientists studying the migration suspected the zebras took their cue from the environmental conditions around them. To test the theory, they focused on two cues that could easily be measured with remote sensing data: vegetation and precipitation. GPS data from collared zebras provided the timing, speed, and direction of the migration. With these variables, they built and tested different models. Was the zebra's departure based on the amount of rain, or was it the greenness of the grass? Turns out, it's both. The zebras feel enough rain and then move. If it's raining hard, they can pace themselves because the water will linger. If it's very green around them, they walk faster. They want to hurry up and get to the salt pans because the vegetation is ripe. There were even more surprises in 2020 when the paths taken by the zebras were plotted. Many migratory animals will take the exact same well-trodden tracks year after year. But the zebras take different paths to the same destination. It seems they use knowledge gained from previous journeys to work out ever more energy-efficient routes. In most years, the rain in the Okavango Delta predicts the greening in the Makati-Kadi Pan. But what happens when those predictions fail? When rainfall is erratic, the zebras have been known to abort their attempts to reach the salt pans and return to the Okavango Delta. Clever zebra. But will they continue to be resilient in the face of increasing drought? The return of this migration is one of great hope. After three generations, the zebra has successfully reconnected to their ancient migratory route. And by understanding the triggers, scientists may understand how climate change will guide the fate of other great migrations. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and leave a zebra in the comments if you like what you saw. Until next time.